Hey guys, thanks for allowing this video to be played in your hearing, I appreciate it. Today I share with you another interesting video in my series. It is hoped that you will appreciate it also. Today's topic is multiple sex partners, and orgy. Humans are socialized to accept a monogamous type of relationship amongst themselves. This means, one man to one woman. This is the ideal throughout the world. Some societies approve polygamous type of relationship, this is a topic for another day. Today, I crave your attention as I look briefly at the practice of polygamous relationships, within your aquarium space. I have several fish species in my system. Each species bred or kept in my system do have a preferred method for breeding. Some fish do have multiple partners while other have one single partner until the partner dies or is removed. Even this may result in varied behavior in the system. Many fish species breeding process involve a dominant male or group of dominant male. Female fish species has little choice as to who their mate will be for many fish species. This is typical in the life of a live bearer. The male or several male will swim towards the female and with good aim, stick the female with its instrument, releasing a bit of mint into the female. The female can decide when it gets pregnant, it can hold this mint in its system, for up to 7 months. The female may even consider to abort the fries, giving birth to dead fish. Several male may stick the same female alternatively. That is why the ratio of male and female should be 1 male to every 3 female in your system. Where too many males exist, females may die due to stress. Not every fish species consider this a bad idea. On the other hand, multiple sex partners or orgies is a reality in the fish world. The Corydoras catfish loves an orgy. Breeding Corydoras, I realize that this is best done with at least 2 males and a single female. They form a pattern where the female lays its eggs and the male stands by to fertilize them. The group, however, prefer swimming together in groups of 5 or more. Some fish species, however, like the Danio, only get the chance of breeding if it's within the dominant rank. The color and size of the fish determines this. Competition amongst fish species for mate is not uncommon. So cichlid would mate with any cichlid of its strain. After the process of spawning has ended, if taken out, and the aquarium or pond is rearranged, it will go with other mates in no time, not caring about its previous partner. Multiple partners are not uncommon in the wild. Shell-dwelling cichlids are amazing. The dominant male would have several ladies in which he alone would mate with and manage their behavior. All females in that aquarium submit to its demand. Consider that behavior for size. Share in the comment section below any fish species which may practice multiple partnership, orgy, etc. Thanks for watching.